Arousal threshold. How easy is it for you to arouse from sleep? If you have the slightest negative pressure, and if that arouses you from sleep, you've got a low arousal threshold. Then you will arouse frequently during sleep, you will wake up sleeping. But if you've got high arousal threshold, whereby you can stop breathing for such a long period of time, and you only arouse after a strong, the stimuli is so strong, then you've got a high arousal threshold. Historically, given that most respiratory events are associated with a cortical arousal, arousals were considered crucial to reopen the upper airway following a respiratory event in OSA. However, 75% of adults with OSA have respiratory events that terminate without an arousal, or the arousal occurs following airway reopening at some stage of the night. So the numerous stimuli contribute to arousal. We do rigorous breathing for 15 minutes before sleep to activate the parasympathetic response. Sleep hygiene is also important in terms of obstructive sleep apnea and sleep disorder breathing. Breathing through the nose, no mobile phones, but slowing down the breath to switch off. Sleep is about activation of the parasympathetic response. If you are go, and you can't switch off your mind at night, and you're having very light sleep, it is a problem. You're going to still feel sleepy. Individuals with low arousal thresholds might arouse before the dilator muscles are able to open up the airway. So we need deep sleep, and deep sleep through the nose. They've looked at this back in the 1980s in terms of blocking the noses of people, and then blocking their mouths, and comparing their sleep quality. Mouth breathing always was light sleep. You cannot have a deep sleep unless you've had about 10 pints of alcohol, and that's not even deep because it's still light. You're feeling waking up, not rested. Delay of arousal with sedatives might help to treat the condition. What we would say is reduce your breathing and nose breathe to have deep sleep. If the upper airway muscle responsiveness is sufficiently poor, then arousal is necessary to initiate airway opening. I'm just going to move on from this a little bit.